in a long while, but I am going on a trip with my family in a few days, and I've still got a lot to do. As you can see, I have done about, well, over half of my nails, because I did the acrylics, but not the polish on one of my hands. But I am waiting on my last load of clothes in the wash. And I apologize for any white noise you might hear from that. And I was going to get started on getting my packing list all worked out. And I remembered that I always have really enjoyed going back to the more simple and writing or book based content from my favorite ASMR creators of all time, the lovely Springbok ASMR. She, similar to myself a few times over, kind of dropped out of the ASMR community in terms of new content, but I like to think that she still lingers and watches videos and enjoys the content just like I have. Even in my creating hiatuses. So, I kind of wanted to pay tribute to her, wherever she is, and make a simple video of my own. Also get my thoughts out on paper and hopefully remember to bring everything that I might need for this trip. We are going for a week. And this is the longest trip that I've been on in a good few years now. But my family and I have always kind of been lucky enough to travel at least once a year for a week or so. My older brother and I living on our own now, not with my parents, so we haven't really prioritized big family excursions during that time. but we're going to another state just to kind of get away. And I notoriously always seem to forget things or leave things places, and so I got my most favorite sounding pen for writing. And so, let me click that over there. And I'm not really as much of a list maker, like writing on lines. As you can see, my legal pad is graph paper because I'm more of a mind map kind of thinker. So I'm just gonna put there we go. Philly. And I hope that you can hear the sounds of the writing. Alright, I turned up the gain on my microphone to even higher than my usual for ASMR so that you can hear the pen on the paper, but it's not really something that I generally do often, so here's hoping. Yes, I'll start by kind of plotting out the different types of activities I'll need things for. So, toiletries is going to be one. As well, just over here on the side, because I won't need as much space to write out the specifics of that. We are gonna be walking around, so do like maybe over here. I'll do like things that I'm gonna be carrying around. EDC stands for everyday carry. I'll probably do a branch off toiletries for like makeup. I would apologize for my handwriting, but I mean, it's upside down for you anyway, so. Thank you. WASD is like the WASD keys on the keyboard. And this was something I got from Etsy. And so it's got a little loop. Because I have a pretty bad pulling at threads of my clothes, so a lot of my clothes end up, can I lean over far enough, end up looking like this, because I will pull out the hems. So I've been looking around at different fidget devices to substitute that, and this one's been working pretty well. Not super obtrusive sound in daily life. So that's something I'm going to be bringing for sure. I'll have a carabiner. I'm going to bring my planner. Camera, although my brother is really into photography, so I might not worry about that. I'll write it down, but I'm not sure. So, clothes. I should probably write down that my mom told me. Leaving so I'm gonna bring 8 outfits, or at least enough pieces to make 8 outfits. Way if I mess up something. Then I'll have enough. And I'm gonna have a raincoat and a light jacket as well, just in case. I don't think I'm and my Crocs, because the Crocs I could wear as slippers at home. Well, not at home, but like at the hotel or Airbnb, wherever we're staying, or I could wear them out. Makeup, I just have to make sure that I check the Mary Kay bag that I got from Goodwill. That's where I keep my makeup, because I mean, it's a Mary Kay bag, so it is intended for makeup, but it's like this. unfurlable, like it rolls up, and it's got like all these clear pockets and hangs, and it's great because it can really hold a lot in case I want to have enough for a lot of different looks or just basics. I can do both. Have a toiletry kit that I keep pretty stocked, but I do have to make sure that it has deodorant, hairbrush, and makeup remover. Figure I might as well have some books. I have to read. The Curse of Strahd. Campaign book. To start dungeon mastering for D&D, and I got the book for the Curse of Strahd campaign for 5th edition, the 5th edition of Dungeons and Dragons. Another D&D book that I got, which I think I have. This is from a publisher called Arcanist Press. Ancestry and Culture, an alternative to race in 5e, which is 5th edition. So if you're unfamiliar with D&D, there are some different ways to categorize and quantify, or not quantify, but like different ways to categorize your characters and the different characters and creatures. And there is the class of character, which is kind of like their role that they play in the adventure, kind of like their job. And there's also their race, and I've always kind of been a little bit frustrated with that qualifier, the race. Specifically, one that is in the, sorry, my laptop just timed out, one that is in the main player's handbook, called Half Elf, other half races, and it's always bugged me because it's like, I've always been like they have elven and different types of elven, but then they have half elf, and it's always bugged me because it's very vague about what the other half is. I think it's kind of understood that it's meant to be like the other, like half elf and then half human, but it's a high fantasy genre, and so I've always found it kind of silly that they kind of assume gotta be something and human. So I had watched an interview with some show on Twitch. I think it was, it might have been Saving Throw show. It was some show. They interviewed one of the authors of this book, and it's a short. Kind of guide to 5th edition that you would get in addition to your handbook. But they spent years researching and figuring out mechanics and stats and ways to replace concept of race within the game, and I thought it was really cool, so I got the book and I cracked it open, as you can see from the spine here, but haven't really dug in or highlighted. Oh, that reminds me, I need to bring a highlighter. I'm really excited to read that and start to incorporate that in games. I haven't run any games myself yet, but I am really excited about it because, like, I have a pretty strong passion for theater, and I do improv comedy now, and have a lot of friends from there, and so I'm excited to hopefully rope them into sitting around a table and rolling dice and pretending to be fantasy creatures and going on adventures and telling stories. And speaking of D&D stuff, if any of you are into D&D and or would be interested in a video that kind of focuses a little more on D&D, whether that is reading through one of the books or tutorial on rolling a character, building a character, or some kind of fantasy roleplay maybe. Obviously I don't have a lot of experience with the ASMR roleplays, but like I said, I'm pretty comfortable acting and I enjoy it, so if that's something that you would be interested in, let me know. And if something has some interest, I might work on putting something together. But yeah, I mean, for now, I'm getting back into creating videos with just simple. Content again. As I say, it has been a while. So let's see, so downtime. I'll probably bring my 3DS. Or not 3DS, Switch. Wow. Super long hair, so I gotta make sure that I have hair ties and some claw clips, because I often like it pulled up. But I can watch that on my phone, that'll be fine. I bring the phone charger bank. That being a fidgety person, I will definitely be picking at if I let it get to be obnoxious. I will pick at my nails. I'll try and bring like a nail brush to clean underneath, because that's necessary. Maybe I'll invest in some AirPods. No, that's not worth worrying about right now. And my makeup bag, my toiletry kit. The bag that I carry my meds in on. I think I'll just put that in there. And then I'll keep a bag for chargers. And then whatever purses I decide. Bring any jewelry? I don't really wear a lot of jewelry, so it probably wouldn't be a good idea to bring any. I've got my wasty fidget, so I think that might be it for that. Yeah, I think that's all I really need. And like my phone. Yeah, but I got that. So let's see. Yeah. All right. So. Yeah, that'll be good. Alright, well, thank you for helping me stay on task as I wrote out my whole plan, and I will see you all. Soon.